Why is Hollywood so damn incompetent in adapting anime shows? What is it that they exactly do to make them unwatchable? How bad did they destroy Death Note? Find out in this video. Stick with me. When we say Hollywood, we actually mean Netflix. But in this case, it is close enough to get our point across. Americanized adaptations of non-American shows and movies are almost always worse. Rare are the examples when this is not the case. Hollywood destroyed Death Note adaptation completely. And we can start with the changed setting. To be perfectly clear, we are not against the setting being outside of Japan. This actually could have been a great step in further exploring the world of Death Note. The problem is that most of the plot is set in a high school, a stereotypical American high school. American high schools we all saw in American movies and shows. In the original, Yagami Light is a high schooler who later goes on to college. But most of the plot of the original is not really connected to high school. Yagami Light is often seen sitting at home, doing his thing, and going outside only to protect himself and the Death Note. In the Netflix adaptation, Light Turner, even his name is a complete disaster. Light Turner, like a page turner. Light Turner is a typical high schooler who deals with typical high school troubles, and then he gets a magical book that kills people. The gravity and seriousness of this situation is drastically lowered by the fact that we hang around with him around high school in a most trivial manner. A lot of the focus is on prom night. They even play music from Top Gun, which we would never hear on a modern prom. Light Turner dramatically enters the scene, in slow motion, of course, and he takes the girl away from some wimp and starts slow dancing with Misa Misa. I apologize, with Mia Sutton. Does this sound like Death Note? All of this implies so much misunderstanding of the characters, of their nuances and their motivations, that it is really hard to believe that someone actually invested $40 million into this project. $40 million! Yagami Light from the anime would never waste his time with nonsense like this. Light from the anime doesn't care about love. He doesn't care about women. He doesn't care about status. And, most of all, he doesn't care about some stupid top hat. Changed rules of the Death Note. Now, you tell me, how is it even possible for someone to adapt a series called Death Note and show the Death Note completely wrong? I know it is hard to believe, but Netflix somehow managed it. Our first complaint is that the Death Note itself is repulsive. They added some stupid art in the corners for no reason at all. No, as a matter of fact, there was a reason. They wanted to make the note occult and mysterious. Also, the Death Note itself looks like other people use it as toilet paper. It looks dirty and it is hard to look at. A complete contrast to the minimalistic depiction from the anime show. The original Death Note doesn't look like they pulled it out of the dumpster. Another, much more serious complaint is that they have changed the rules of the Death Note. The producers didn't even have to think too hard about the rules, because all the rules are listed in the damn book. One of the most important rules in the Death Note is that once written, a death cannot be reversed. And that's exactly what the producers changed in the adaptation. Idiots! A big part of the charm and ingenuity of the original anime show comes from the way Light uses the rules and bends them to his will, without ever actually breaking them. including the rule that the deaths are irreversible. But in the adaptation, if you burn the page where the death is written, then it doesn't really matter. It won't happen. Also, in the original, Yagami Light can control the actions of his victims only several minutes before they die. In the Netflix adaptation, on the other hand, crucial plot points revolve around the fact that Light Turner could control his victims days before their actual death. Death Note is not a zombie brainwashing note or space and time controlling note. No, it is just a death note. This is a very lazy and irresponsible change, which completely changes the roles and the whole dynamic of the show. The lack of crucial characters. A lot of the characters are completely missing from the adaptation, starting with Light's mother and sister. Well, mother is not really written out. They changed her into a generic victim, thus diminishing Light's and his father's depth as characters. Instead of getting a subtle and deep message, like in the original anime, that a psychopath and sociopath, like Yagami Light, can come even from a house filled with love and dedication. Instead of all that, the adaptation chooses to kill his mother so that Light Turner could exact his revenge upon, of all things, mobsters. Mobsters. The mobsters that killed his mother. We replace a subtle commentary on the development of a criminal mind with a generic story about revenge. Which is just one more example how the producers made the whole story stupider. Also, Rem is completely missing from the story. And that has a big consequence. Mia Sutton, without Rem, can have no proper development of her character. It also shows even less of the Shinigamis and their world and their motivations. Not to mention that it simplifies the plot way too much. Ray Pember, my favorite by the way, the unlucky FBI agent who has to follow Yagami Light in the original, is completely missing from the adaptation, which has two big consequences. The bust scene from the anime, which is ingenious and iconic in its own way, is completely absent from the adaptation. By losing this scene, we get less of Light's character development, and we don't get to see how calm, calculated, and ruthless he really is. Also, not having Ray Pember means that we don't get the scene where Light manipulates Ray into killing other FBI agents. And not only that, one of the best scenes in the anime, a scene where Light talks with the wife of Ray Pember and where he slowly drags out information out of her in order to mercilessly kill her in the end, is completely absent from the adaptation. Cutting this scene out is an unforgivable sin, in my opinion. They cut out a scene like that, but they put in a slow-motion grab-ass during the prom. I mean, come on. Good choice, producers, good choice. To quote one of the most iconic YouTubers ever, "What were they thinking?" And now we get to the most horrid and unforgivable sin that the adaptation does, and that is changing the characters, making them unrecognizable. Yagami Light from the anime, a calm person, extremely intelligent, attractive, charming, emotionless, a psychopath and sociopath, a man of ideals, no matter how horrible those ideals are. Someone who would stop at nothing to achieve his goal. He is not interested in earthly goods, like money, women, or drugs. A great character he is. And being like that, he is the worst possible person to actually get his hands on a Death Note. Light Turner, on the other hand, is shown as an over-emotional teenager. He is not calm, he is not ingenious, he is not driven by ideals. Even the way he reacts when he first sees Ryuk is almost laughable when compared to the original. While the original Light Yagami quickly recovers from that surprise and uses his newfound knowledge to improve his powers and the control of the Death Note, Light Turner can't get a hold of himself for much too long after he first sees Ryuk. Almost everything Light Turner represents is a complete opposite to Light Yagami, and that makes the whole narrative crumble. The Death Note was never meant to fall into the hands of a wimp, and that drastically lowers the quality of the entire story. Furthermore, Misa Misa from the anime is dim-witted but eternally devoted to Light. Misa Misa would never manipulate Light except to ensure that he doesn't fool around with other girls. Women. Light from anime wanted to date other girls more so as a cover, and not because he needs love and affection, because, as we already said, he's a goddamn psychopath. Mia Sutton from the adaptation, on the other hand, is a rotten and manipulative bitch, and a complete contrast to Misa Misa. If anything, Mia Sutton resembles more Light Yagami from the anime. The idea to switch two characters in such a way between anime and the adaptation results in a complete change of the dynamics between the main characters and their overall influence on the plot. And all it does is make for a worse story. Without Rem and her influence on Mia makes the character of Mia completely unlikable and difficult to watch. There's plenty of small gripes we have with the adaptation. Here we're talking about Ryuk and the way they change him from the anime. Ryuk from the anime would never push Yagami Light into committing crime. Ryuk is there as an observer, and because he is bored out of his mind. He was never meant to be an evil genie from the lamp. I'm sorry, genie from the Death Note, as he is depicted in the adaptation. Furthermore, the brutality of gore is so ridiculously overblown that they completely lose the desired effect. On the contrary, instead of a tone of seriousness and fear they're supposed to instill, most of the viewers will start laughing at them when they see how ridiculously bad they are executed. Again, a complete contrast to the anime, where most of the deaths are committed by a simple heart attack. And then, in the adaptation, we see a man get decapitated by a ladder. A ladder. What were they thinking, indeed? This is a great tell how much producers got wrong. It literally looks like a scene from a scary movie, or some other parody. The fact that we have to mention scary movie in the same context with the Death Note is really disheartening, and is a great sign how much Hollywood disrespected Death Note. But we left the worst for last, and that is the depiction of L. To fully understand how much they destroy the character of L, one of the most iconic and brilliant detectives in all of anime, first you need to know who L really is. L is calm, endlessly intelligent, super rich, capable, adept at martial arts, with perfect detective capabilities, and just enough funny quirks. For example, the way he sits or the way he holds his phone, the way he talks, the way he obsesses about sweets, to make him unique and likable. That is L from anime. Quirks like that is something that other detectives from shows and stories often lack. For example, Lunge from Monster. While in Hollywood, the only quirk most detectives get is that they are alcoholics. L from the adaptation is a complete disaster, and is one of the main reasons why most people couldn't even watch this adaptation. L in the adaptation is shown as emotional, autistic, insecure, incompetent, tactless, and without tactic. One of the biggest strengths of the original anime is the clash of two great brilliant minds, L and Yagami Light, and showing us how different they are, and at the same time, how similar they are. They are two sides of a brilliant coin. But when we take into account how much they made light Turner of the adaptation, incompetent, stupid, and emotional, and how much they made L from the adaptation, incompetent, stupid, and emotional, we can freely say that L and Turner are also two sides of the same poor coin. But in the case of the adaptation, the depiction of clash between L and Turner is pitiful and difficult to watch. The greatest sin that Hollywood or Netflix committed here is instead of showing a great story to a great big mass of people, they do the exactly opposite. Thousands, maybe millions of potential fans are forever discouraged of giving this anime a shot. And not only giving a shot to Death Note. This adaptation is so bad that many of potential viewers will never even try anything that anime medium has to offer. Maybe one day Hollywood will discover the way to translate the nuances and subtleties of anime shows into live-action adaptations. The Death Note adaptation by Netflix did not accomplish this, not even close. If you like this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Follow us on social networks. Also, check out our anime snapshots and our top lists. That's it for today. Bye-bye.